completely agree with Sonal, so not repeating any of the points, just making two points. One is the use of the word labor force participation rates already biases the analysis towards women's own decisions to either be in the labor force or not to be in the labor force. So when you see lower number of women, quote unquote, working, and I'm going to talk about that in a minute, you automatically assume that that's because women must have withdrawn from the labor force. So I use the term all the time because that's the one that's used, but I think there is an implicit bias just in this terminology of labor force participation rates because it is completely what economists call a supply side story, that is supply of women's labor. Now, to elaborate on this point, you think of a 2x2 table where you have paid and unpaid on one side and in the house and outside the house on the other side. So you can have four types of work that women do, and I'm not talking about domestic work or care work or reproductive work. This is economic activities, which means that if a man had been doing it, that man would have been counted as a working person, right? So these are those activities. And there are, in these four cells of paid, unpaid, at home, outside, in each of these four cells are economic activities. But when we measure labor force participation, it's typically outside the home and paid. So the three other boxes never get measured. And, you know, I can go on talking about the measurement issue. But basically, this is what I call the gray zone, which tends to fall between the cracks of the measurement system. So if somebody came to your house and said, in the majority of the year, did you work? And there the point that Sonal made about availability of jobs is crucial. And if I didn't work in the majority of the year, I'll say, no, I did not. Did you work in the year any time for 30 days? The answer to that also could have been no. I may have worked for 15 days in something on a construction site, or at home, you know, stitching some bindis or whatever, but I will fall through the cracks of the measurement system. So about the measurement, what I want to say is that we have to think of ways of measuring this gray zone, and that's really not even NSS or IHDS or anything. It's really a fundamental, misunderstanding is perhaps too strong a word, but a lack of comprehension of these four cells within which women's economic work falls.